About a month back, I noticed this one guy was all over my Twitter feed. I saw him chugging beers and downing a whole bottle with a tomato spit. Everyone was sharing his videos. I noticed people called him the king. I wondered, who is this man? And how did he get so famous outside of China, where Twitter is blocked? So I went all the way to Hebei to find him.
Hello, 大家好，我叫刘世超，也可以叫我河北胖仔。因为我本人长得也比较胖一点，然后我那个饭店的名字就叫胖仔火锅。后来从那个时候我走到了这个网络上，我就给自己起了一个名字叫河北胖仔。
For 河北胖仔 became Twitter's king.
非常的简单。
He had already found fame on Kuaishou.A short video platform in China similar to TikTok. Easy to navigate even for users who aren't smartphone savvy, Kuaishou has been most popular in China's smaller cities and towns, offering a window into rural life. But I was still curious, how did he get so big on Kuaishou? He actually first started breaking bricks.
话说三年前我闲着没事我翻手机看到了一个短视频，我看到了他劈砖头。就是劈砖头他作假，我有点看不下去，我就拍了一个开砖头的视频。当时用的手机像素特别不好，而且就是特别模糊的那种。后来我就看到了一个喝啤酒的一个，因为平时我也喜欢喝啤酒嘛，我也就尝试着自己拍了一个，然后也获得了很多的别人的点赞和评论。57秒喝了7杯的扎啤杯的啤酒。当时那个视频就比较大火，然后说有200多万的点击量，200多万。我第一个视频我发出去以后，我一晚上没有睡觉，我都在回复他们的评论和私信。
Kuaishou's user base is mostly rural, so you'll often find antics geotypical of farm life, from wacky stunts and pranks to eating questionable food.But things got so crazy that in 2018, China's internet regulator started cracking down on these videos. Platforms like Kuaishou and TikTok had to remove so-called inappropriate content, and that included binge drinking. Peng Zai's most popular video, which had 12 million views, was taken down. In it, he drinks a mix of beer, a high alcohol spirit called Baijiu, a raw egg, and Pepsi.But then, his old drinking videos found new life outside of China, and it happened without him knowing.
当时我感觉到就是我的快手上莫名其妙的收到了很多的私信和评论，他们都跟我说，胖哥你在海外火了一个视频。我说在哪边？他们说推特上。后来我就想知道谁拿我的视频在那边给我发了一下，后来慢慢的联系我就找到了他。他是美国的一个我的一个粉丝，他把我的一个视频拿到了那边，然后在那边这个视频当时就火起来了。
After a few days of people sharing his content, Peng Zai decided to create his own Twitter account, and it gained more than 70,000 followers in less than a month.
拍视频的话，我没有提前规划过，今天上午想起来，下午就要拍，我就跟我弟弟打一个电话，稍微合计一下就开始拍，一边拍一边想，然后他会。简单的剪辑一下，我的视频里边比较喜欢放一些比较爷们儿、比较阳刚一点的这种音乐，一定要配到一块儿，才会感觉视频才好看。他们都非常喜欢我配的音乐，每一个视频下边的评论，他们都在问我，胖仔，能把音乐推荐给我吗
？But crossing to global fame hasn't been easy because internet culture in the West is different. Just a day before I met him.Peng Zai's Twitter account was temporarily suspended. He believes it was because of a video of himself catching a live chicken, which would have been okay in China. His fans started a campaign called Free Peng Zai, and within a day, he recovered his account.
他们特别特别热情。我做的视频有时候需要配这个英文字幕的话，有的粉丝就是自愿出来帮助我。我把视频发给他们，他们帮我添加完英文字幕。然后再发给我，我再上传。 最开始我涉及到就是接触这个网络的时候，因为那时候是在靠这个喝酒在拍视频，然后是我的家人是非常的反对，就为这个拍这个视频，我和我老婆吵架，吵了很多次架，我中间也停顿了好几次，但是有时候会舍不得一些，自己的粉丝，他们感觉好像感觉他们在等我一样，我知道我拍这些视频会，因为喝太多酒，知道会伤身体，但是我会控制到我的能力范围之内。但是呢，没有说固定的去工作，偶尔闲下来，会拍拍短视频，会做做直播，有时候做一些微商也能增加一部分的收入。但是我的目的还是想再开一家餐馆。我暂时是拍一些我自己做饭的内容，我会把中国的美食，以及就是每个地方的风俗和习惯一些特色，我会带到这个国际上，就这样。
收下来。对，是，对，这边使劲儿。
啊！
看到了，这手艺疼吧？
不疼，
一点都不疼，是吧？
哇！
主要是这个力气。哇！看到没有？
拆那边。